All right, the skeleton for the shower stall, the panels, is now attached to the wall. As you can see, this is the configuration that the instructions showed to do at the right heights, leveling up the boards, and it should be all ready to go. The way this shower was designed, these perimeter boards here are the 1x3s, but then all the rest of these interior boards here are all 2x3s, and there were certain sizes that you had to cut to. A lot were the same, so I didn't have to be specific with everyone, but and then there's that little notch there that was required so that because the tub surround, or well, it's whatever you want to call it, the backing, back walls, because it's two pieces, instead of bringing each piece into the corner and having a seam in the corner, which would be an ideal place for leaks to happen, the one piece is actually L-shaped, makes a right turn there and comes out. This is where the shelves are for the shampoo and so on that are on there. So the one piece slides into this and then tucks into there, and then the other piece comes into it this way, so that and I believe I'll see when I get to that part of the construction that you fasten them together first before you put them up to the wall. But then they fit into the wall this way because these pieces are all here. They form the skeleton for the tub surround. It's not heavy duty, it's very light duty plastic, so in order to hold the stresses, pressures, whatever you want to say, to keep the thin plastic from breaking, the structure of the wood is what's holding it in place. So that's why it was designed this way. This isn't the way a one-piece fiberglass tub unit or shower unit would be. It'd be self-supporting, but this one, of course, isn't. So there was a lot more fooling around, a lot more carpentry involved in this than I'd have preferred. But for the price, I couldn't complain about it. And the truth of the matter is, we didn't find any other 34-inch corner showers of any price that were more substantial. It was just, this was the only real option that I could find. So, and I didn't want to spend, of course, like $3,000-$5,000 on something deluxe, but hopefully after doing all this work it'll be all set. Next thing I have to do is put the base back on here and attach the drain, and then the walls, and then finally the glass front, the tracks in the glass front with the door. And then of course the finish off the faucet here, but that's just the escutcheon and then the lever, so that's not a big deal. And then of course the shower head, but those are all minor things. Excuse me. So what I did here, I do a lot of work when I'm doing like internal carpentry like this. I prefer to use screws and my drill to attach them. I know they're good and tight that way. But with this configuration, I decided to just use my nailing gun, my big angle nailer there with, let's see if I can find a nail here quick to show you. With this size nail, it's the only kind that I have. I mean, I use it for all kinds of framing construction. But part of my reasoning is I need to hold them in place level. And I'm going through here with the 2x, inch and a half, and a half inch of drywall. And then I've got plaster and lath behind that, which is about an inch, till I hit a stud. And there weren't, in this corner, there weren't studs everywhere I needed them to be, so I could run screws in all day long and it still wouldn't hit much more than plaster and lath. I did have one running down here and one running down here, and then in the very corner, in the corner there. but it worked a whole lot easier to just use the nailing gun to put them in and got them in place. And as you can see, they're solid. Now, some of these nails are just in through all what I just described, the drywall and the plaster and lath, but they're still holding, and the ones that did hit the stud will hold them in place that they really can't move. So I'm hoping that will be secure enough. I was not going to rip out all the plaster and lath and reframe the inside of the wall to adapt to this framing structure here. That would have been insane to do that. The only other way I could have stiffened this up a little more is if perhaps instead of putting drywall as the backer, I put a piece of plywood, perhaps a half inch or even thicker plywood, if I really wanted to get into that time and expense. If I'd have done that, then yes, I could have run screws in and I would have bit the plywood a little bit better. But then you also have the issue of the moisture too with the plywood. With this purple, the moisture resistant drywall, at least I'm fighting against any of the humidity and the other water splashes and things from the shower. So I still think this was the better way to go. So now we're ready for the next phase. When I get the shower drain in and the base is permanently in place, I'll come back to you and show you that, and then we'll continue this project. So thank you for watching. Well, we've run into a problem. I had assembled this drain exactly the way the instructions showed. It was as tight as I could make it, and it leaks. I dumped some water into the pan here just to see how the drain would work. I had, of course, the screen on, and then I was able to see from underneath with a flashlight to check for leaks, and lo and behold, I saw trickles of water running down the side of the pipe. So, this design, I guess, is just not that great. I, in fact, also watched a YouTube video put out by the company that makes these drains, and I confirmed that I actually did put it together exactly the way the instructions showed from this, you know, from this shower. The guy on the video did the same thing I did, and I did it, you know, according to what the instructions in the paper said. Basically, what you have is, this is the PVC pipe here. This is the outer drain enclosure, slips over the top of that. Underneath, it's has a friction ring and a rubber gasket, and then a lock washer that you plastic that you tighten it down to the shower base. That was all done. Then put the base in place, and then there's a rubber gasket that goes between the PVC pipe and the inside edge of this drain. You shove it down, and then I put it in the correct way, it wasn't upside down, and then there's this lock ring here that you tighten down to push down on top of the gasket, and that's supposed to spread it and make it waterproof. There is a little type of key thing that you put on there to tighten it down with a screwdriver, slotted screwdriver. I have it tightened down as tight as I can make it, and it's still leaking. So what do I want to do? Do I want to take this all out, take everything off again, get some other kind of drain somewhere else, spend more money on this stupid project than I already have, or can I come up with another solution? Well, I'm going to try the simple solution first. I'm going to take my silicone caulk, I'm going to go around, sorry about that with the camera, I'm going to go around the outside edge here. Again, there's already a bead of silicone underneath this lip, between this lip and the shower base. That's not where I think it's leaking, but I will put extra caulk there. Not a whole lot that it becomes a blob, but just enough that if there should be a little bit of a leak in there, that'll cover it. Then I'm going to take the silicone and run a bead around the inside top here of where the pipe comes up. And then I'm also going to try to get a bead around the edge, the outside edge of this lock ring. So that technically there should be nothing exposed where it could leak. Everything will be silicone and PVC or silicone and plastic, so there should be no opening anywhere where water could trickle down in between. Whether this will work or not, I don't know. I have let this dry overnight so that there isn't any moisture in there. I wiped it down with a paper towel. I'll wipe it off again to make sure there's no dirt or anything on there to try to see if the silicone can bond real well. Then all I can do is let it dry for another 24 hours and see if it's going to leak again. If it does, I don't know what to do, but that's a kind of a dumb design. You'd think they'd have a better way to do it, but they don't. So it is what it is, and we'll see what happens. Well, the silicone caulking around the drain worked. It no longer leaks. I tested it. And I also have been able to put the two wall pieces together the way they belong. I'll pull it off in a second to show you because it's not on permanently yet. And as you can see, I was able to drill a hole through it to get the faucet valve through, and that will work fine there. Even though it's not centered on the wall, it's the best I could do. And of course, the escutcheon will go right there. The instructions on how to put this together, I had to deviate from a bit just because of the issue I had with the drain. The way they wanted you to do it was after you assembled the two wall pieces together, was then to mount them to the base with screws from the back drilling into the base. There's a lip on the bottom of the wall pieces, of course, and then a lip on the back of the base, and then just screw them together that way. But because I already had the base permanently put into its position, I can't pull it back out now, especially now that I did all that silicone caulking on the drain. I can't move it. So I'm not going to be able to get behind the wall to run screws through it. So it's not a major problem. When I pull the wall piece out, what I will do is I will run a heavy bead of silicone along the lip on the base, which sticks up about an inch. So heavy bead of silicone, and then I'll set the wall pieces in place there, and there won't be any leaks. I mean, it wouldn't happen because of the caulking plus the lip on the back. So I'm not worried about that. I'm also not worried about the back kicking out because it really can't. I will be attaching trim pieces along here for the shower doors, and they're going to screw right into the wall, through the wall into the one-bys that were on there. So when I get all that done, everything's going to be against the wall. Nothing's going to move, even if there aren't screws in the back there. So sometimes with remodeling, you got to make your own instructions to make it work, you know what I mean? So that's my next move. I'll come back to you in a minute. I've got to pull this off anyhow. It's just set in place. It's not permanently, you know, permanently affixed. I just put it up there to see, so that you could see that it was, that it was going to work, and that I could see it was going to work, that it did fit the wood framing the way it was supposed to. So I'll pull it off, and I'll show you how I mounted it from the back. That was their plan. This whole shower has been so complicated, unnecessarily so, but I guess it's because it's so cheaply made. They basically put the responsibility on the owner to prep the site so it could handle the cheap plastic and it wouldn't break and it would hold up. A better quality shower, even a corner shower, you wouldn't have to fool around with as much as I did with this one. So, but at any rate, it is what it is, and it's the one we got. So let me come back to you in just a second. Now, as you can see, I'm standing kind of behind the shower walls. You can see how they were attached together. Basically, what they had you do is drill holes. Oops, sorry, I didn't want to get that light in there. Drill holes through both pieces and then run a bolt, washers and a nut through, and then there are several of them, I think those are six down through, to put them together. Couple things with that, they all had these little indentational bumps here, like you can see here. That was your guide for drilling the holes, and that's where the bolts went through. To make sure that you had them even, the suggestion was clamp the piece together with a vice grips so that it couldn't move while you're drilling it. So I did that. I used a couple vice grips. And then also what I did was I just made sure everything was going to fit together, put the bolts in loosely. And I pulled everything back apart again. And then what I had to do was along this surface in between, but on the shower side in front of the bolts, I had to run a bead of silicone through there so that it can't leak back in, that this joint is basically waterproof now. So that was another component of their construction plans with this. But so it is in one piece. Like I said, I measured my distance and drilled with my hole saw, and that came through. And as you can see, as I said before, this base does have a lip on it, so if I put a nice bead of silicone, heavy bead of silicone, along the inside of that lip and then set the base on it, the walls on the base, it's not going anywhere. You can see there is a little lip on the bottom of the base pieces, so everything will be okay with that, and I think it'll be all waterproof, and it'll be secure that it won't come loose or crack or anything. We'll see once I get it all in, but that's the plan, so I'll come back to you with the next. Okay, as you can see, the walls are permanently in place now. Put screws along the top edge. I'm going to put a screw down in each bottom corner. Keep in mind this will get even tighter here when I put the track on for the door, when it screws everything back against the wall. So it'll be solid, it won't move anywhere. Big bead of silicone underneath all the way around so that won't leak. And I managed to get the faucet in place, and it does work. I'm not going to turn it on because I don't want water everywhere. But trust me, it does. This was my main concern because of the way these back panels here are not flat. They're kind of rounded. And since I had one of the main studs came down right here, what would have been centered on this, I had to jog everything over this way a little bit. I was afraid that I'd get too much of an angle on here that it wouldn't sit right, but it is. It's good and tight. The escutcheon's good and tight. The valve is connected properly. I was able to get it just below this shelf, like this, I don't know, reinforcing ridge or whatever you want to call it on here, decoration, what have you. Maybe it's just to make the plastic stronger, I suppose. But it worked out okay, even though it's off-center. And as you can see, you know, with the shower, it isn't perfect as far as centered. But given this is an old house and I didn't want to start cutting studs out, and I'm trying to adapt this shower kit to it, I'm not unhappy. The shower head is also slightly off-center, again, because there's that stud to the right of it. But it'll still all work well inside here. The water will be contained inside. When you get in to the shower, there'll be, you know, you won't have a problem with that, I don't think. Now, they were suggesting that you should put your fixed panel, it's a two-panel glass door, put your fixed panel opposite the shower rather than the door, so that just in case you turn it on with the door open, you wouldn't be getting water all over the floor. So that means I'm going to put my fixed panel on this side and put the door on this side, and it'll slide open like this to get in and out of the shower. It's designed that you can put the door on either side, so I'll show you that when we get to that. But so far, despite all the fooling around and the adaptation necessary, we're still on track to get this project done, and then this third floor shower will make, at least functionally, this third floor bathroom complete. Got a lot more decorating to do, but the plumbing will then be done. So I will, I guess what I'll do is I'll stop the videos at this point. I have a whole bunch in a string. I don't want any one video to be too long and make a second part to this. I don't know yet, but we'll see how it goes. Just keep watching the website. All right, thank you for watching, and please subscribe to our channel. Okay, next phase of the shower is this aluminum frame where the fixed panel and the glass door, both of those are glass, attach. This is just being dry fit right now. It's not attached to anything. As you can see, this particular shower, this assembly has six pieces. You've got your two tracks, your upper and your lower, and then on this side you have a panel where the glass sticks into, same on the other side, and then behind that, if you can see it here, I don't want to pull it all apart, you can see maybe that there's another aluminum panel that goes all the way down. That's where the shower mounts to the wall, and it's a multiple step process. This whole shower thing has been labor intensive and lots of weird directions to how to do it. But so what I have to do, I'm at this point now, is to dry fit it. I have to get it so that it's plumb and it's kind of sitting in the middle of this channel groove here, certainly that it would, sorry about that, so certainly that the bottom track is somewhat centered on the lip of the base, as you can see there, so that you know, so that it's not going to leak either way. And once I get that centered up, then what they want you to do is to actually pull this section of these four pieces out. They're screwed together. You can't see it from here, but right in this joint, I ran two screws in from the back side of this piece into the hoop here on all four sides. And you had to put it in a certain way so that if you see here, you can see there's like a recessed track here where the glass is going to go. Glass or the well, and then above it is a little runway track for the shower, sliding shower door. And then the very top is flat. Same is the case on the bottom. You just have to be careful when you're doing that, that you get it put together the right way. But then after I get it plumbed up, then I'm going to take this frame off and just work on these two pieces, the trim, the brackets where it fits into. I have to drill holes through the plastic and run screws in to the wall to permanently mount them. And then after that's in, they're in place where they're supposed to be, that everything is plumb and centered as best you can get it, and then what I have to do is actually fasten this bracket, the frame here, to the bracket, running screws through it so that everything is locked permanently in place. And then the only thing that would be left then is to assemble the two glass pieces, the fixed piece and the shower door, the sliding shower door. And this is set up that you can go right-handed or left-handed with the sliding shower door. Now the instructions show putting the door on the right hand side and the fixed piece on the left. I'm doing the opposite of that just because of where I had to locate my faucet. I certainly wasn't going to put the shower faucet on the outside wall. That wouldn't have made any sense. You put it on the inside wall, of course, and that's where the rest of my plumbing was. So because of that, I will be putting my fixed panel on the right hand side and the shower door will go on the left, so that when you get in and out of the shower, you'll grab the door here and slide it that way and then just step in this way. And that'll work. That's not a problem. So I'll come back to you when this is in place, and then we'll talk about the assemblage of the doors, the panel and the door. I keep calling them doors. They both look about the same. Just one isn't going to move. So, and then after they're done, of course, then I've got to silicone caulk every joint to make sure that nothing can leak. So we'll come back with those phases, because The shower's almost done now, so we'll see, and then I'll show you it working. Not with anybody in it, of course, but you know what I mean. Okay, we're coming along here. Further steps are done. After the wall jams are screwed in place and they're tight, then you're supposed to slide the frame. I'm sorry, I'm looking at that instead of where the camera is. Slide the frame, tuck it in there, and then put it into position, obviously, where it's going to go. So that's what I've done. Then you would think, well, you've got to fasten this frame to the wall jams, but no, not yet. These stupid instructions. You're supposed to take the I'm getting ahead of myself. You're supposed to take the door, the sliding door, not the fixed panel of glass, and assemble it. Now, it's got four rollers here, two top, two bottom. They clip over. There's a hole in both sides, and in the bottom they clip over, and then there's a screw that holds them in place. And these are going to ride in this track on the top here. I didn't get to that. And also on the bottom. And then they want you to assemble the handle inside and outside. And when that's done, what you're supposed to do is place it inside the shower and just stand it there. Now, it seems silly to me to have to do that, I realize, because you're working around it then for the rest of the work that you have to do. And maybe I'll find out when I go to install it that was the right thing to do, but it's a pain in the butt to try to work around when you got more work that you have to do. I'll explain that in a second. So that's standing there. It's on the cardboard. It's safe. It's out of, it won't fall, you know, so that's good. Now then, the next thing is to take the fixed panel, this piece, and tuck it into the track on the bottom, and in the wall there's a track that it slides into. Okay, shove it in there so that it's tight. Once that's in place, then there are two little clips to hold it in place and screw into the frame here, top, and of course on the bottom, so that it really can't move. It wiggles a little bit, yeah, because I haven't put all the gaskets in, but it's fixed. Now, why they wanted to do you to do that before this frame is anchored to the wall, I don't know, but that's what they said to do. Then you had to take, let me see it up in there. There are three holes in each side of the, or on each of the inside edges of the wall panels. The wall brackets. You have to drill hole. You have to shove the frame into them tight where it's going to be permanently, and then you have to drill holes through those holes into the frame itself, so that you can attach three screws on each side to anchor it permanently in place. Now, here's the problem I had. They suggest using a 3/32 bit to drill into the inside there, and then they've got these half-inch like self-tapping screws. And the hole with 3/32 is just too small to start those screws. I tried it by hand. I tried it with my cordless drill, and it's too small, so I had to use a bigger bit. I don't think I went quite up to an eighth, but I used a bigger bit, drilled a bigger hole. It was still difficult to get those screws to start because of the configuration on, because they've got these boring heads on before the threading part of the screw. But I did manage to get all six in. I started them with my cordless drill, or my cordless screwdriver, just to get the RPMs up to get it to bite enough. By hand, it was impossible. I kept dropping screws. So once I got those in place, got them started, then I could finish it off by hand. Hand tightening everything just so that the drill doesn't make everything too tight and bend anything. It's only aluminum, you know. So I got all six of those in, and the frame is completely secure now. It's not going anywhere. You know what I'm saying? And then this fixed panel is in place. It's not going anywhere. And now I'm up to the next phase, which is to put this gasket here, tucking it on the inside of the fixed glass panel into the frame there, so I guess it makes it good and tight. Oh, the only problem is the tool they want you to use to do that is the plastic box handle. You know what I'm saying? On boxes, sometimes they have these plastic handles, and on the end they're kind of spade shaped so that they hook into the cardboard. Well, the problem is I have no idea where the box handle is anymore because I've gotten rid of the box a long time ago. And you know, didn't realize that was going to be an assembly tool. So I've got to figure out something else. Plastic, I can't use metal, I can't use one of my screwdrivers or something to push that in for fear of damaging the glass or putting, you know, damaging or cutting this. This is just like a light rubber, you know, so I don't want to damage it. So I guess that's why they have used the plastic piece to do it, so it's not too hard. But you can't push it in by hand. It's just you need something a little skinnier and stiffer to be able to shove it in there. So that's the stage I'm at right now. And once that's in, then I can go to the next phase. So we're almost finished. We just have to finish the gaskets and the rubber stops, hang the door, and then we're going to caulk all the way around everywhere. So I'll come back to you when we get to that phase. Hopefully we're almost done. All right, thanks for watching. All right, the shower is just about finished. Door is on and it is functioning well. I'll show you here. Slides nicely. Just a couple things with this. That gasket on the back corner there I showed you the last video was a real pain to try to get in, and since I did not have a box handle to use as a pusher, I had to use a substitute. I needed something that wasn't metal. It wasn't too sharp because I didn't want to damage the rubber gasket, so I came up with this paint stick, paint stir. It was perfect. It pushed it all in nicely for me. So just a little tip in case you need something like that. Also, these doors, as you can see, they're not tight against each other. The way they keep things waterproof is there are a series of gaskets here on these edges. Not like that one. These went on a whole lot easier. There's one on that side of the door, on this side of the door, and then on this left side of the glass wall that doesn't move. And then there's a gasket here along this edge. This one was a pain to put in. It pinches in the track there, but it was a real pain to try to get in. I don't know why it was so tight, but it was. But I got it, and as you can see, there are these little catches up there to hold the door in place, either open or closed. I don't know if you can see those up in there or not. They're up in there, and just when it comes over, the door, the sliding door itself wasn't bad. The upper rollers hung from the inside of the track here, and then on the bottom, they fit on the track too. To get them in place, there's a little spring clip section on the outside here that you push down to lower them down to clip them on, and then it pulls them up. If there's still too much wiggle room, there's an adjustment screw here on the top rollers that you can actually lower them down or pull them up, depending what you need as far as tightness goes, you know, as far as so that it doesn't, so that it can't come out of the bottom track is what you really don't want. So that worked out well, and now I basically just have to caulk. Well, I still have to put the shower nozzle on there. That was something I wasn't worried about. Also, there's a little piece that there's nothing in the directions about it. But this little triangular piece of plastic, I'm guessing, goes up in that corner because the shower, the back side of that is not, it's rounded, it's not squared. So there's a little gap there that you could get water down in behind. So I've got to figure out how I can put that in place and seal it, probably just silicone it, and then that'll protect the back side from any kind of moisture getting in. What I'll have to do when I finish off the when I get the drywall finished off, spackled and then painted, is I'll run a bead of silicone along the top back edge of the shower walls there where it touches the drywall to make sure that that stays waterproofed as well. So now the scheme for caulking here is they're telling you to caulk the outside edges along the outside here and then down along there and then up the other side and then even in the corners down in there they want you to caulk extra so that nothing can get through so that it stays perfectly dry. So we'll see how that goes. I'll see what I think I need to do. It'll be 24 hours then before the silicone will be dry enough to test, but I'm not expecting any leaks. So we will give you a final brief look at the shower in operation, and then this project, at least this part of the bathroom project, will be complete. People can take showers in here, and then the next phase will be dealing with the old walls. So I will come back to you with the next video. Okay, we're finished with everything in the shower except for testing it to make sure that it's watertight. I put the put a shower head on. It's one that was in use before that somebody wanted, so I'm putting that one on rather than the one that came with the faucet. Not a problem. I still can put the regular one on if I want. I've also caulked it as per instructions right down along the edge of the trim there where it touches the plastic, down in the corner, all along the outside edge here, and then up that wall, of course, all the way up. And then also they said put a bead between the trim and this fixed glass panel here right along the top there. So I put a bead along there. So I think that should do it. I will come back with a final display to show that it actually works and it's functional. But that'll be, like I said, 24 hours dry time for the silicone caulk. So we'll come back. Okay, I have allowed the silicone caulk to cure for about 24 hours. So we're ready for the wet test. First time I'm turning this completed shower on, I put this specialty head on. Somebody in the house wanted it, so I don't know what it's going to do, but we'll see. All right, here we go. As you can see, shower is hitting the far wall, which is good that I have it caulked, and it's going down the drain. Now I have to, when I turn this off, I have to get down underneath it and check for any kind of leaks, but just wanted to see what it looked like where the water would strike. And it's nice and warm, turning over to hot. Yeah, it's good and hot. Too hot to just use hot. And we turn it back off. As I said before, I have to finish off the head up there a little bit. The drywall there where the escutcheon is, and secure that pipe a little more. But other than that, I think it's going to work fine. So, this wraps up the shower portion of the project. If I don't come back to you with another video, it means there were no leaks and there's no reason to say anything else. So hopefully that'll be the case. All right, thank you for watching, and please like and subscribe to our channel as we continue talking about country living on a shoestring.